I was singing a song, a little ditty was in my head, and I told Bay about it, and he was like, what is that? It's Sobbing Women, Sobbing Women. It's from Seven Brides from Seven Brothers. Do y'all remember that movie? This movie is from 1954. It was produced by Warner Brothers. It's a musical. It's a good musical. Let me just point this out. Seven Brides for Seven Brothers is a fantastic musical. It's based on the rape of the Sabine women. The rape of the Sabine women is sort of a tale, which is how the original Romans got their women, because they didn't have enough women. So they went and they captured women. They threw a festival and they said, hey, everybody, all families from the area, come to our party. Leave your weapons at home. You're not going to need the weapons. We're going to give you booze and food. We're going to have a good time. Now, back in the day, calorie was worth a lot. So someone's out there offering you booze and food and a good time. Someone's going to play the lyre, like the lyre, lyre.
Lyre.
The harp thing. I don't know. They're going to play some old instruments. You're like, okay, I'm going to go. Someone's throwing a block party. All right, I'm going to go to this block party. Turns out Romulus and the like, they had different ideas. They were like, when everyone's drunk and having a good time, we're going to take all their wives and daughters. And the Romans were like, wow, that is a really good idea. That is a good way to get women. Just capture them. 2022, we're looking back on this. We know you're not supposed to kidnap women and force them to marry you. This is actually a practice that still goes on in parts of the world. And it's sad. But the movie, the musical, the 1954 musical, Seven Brides for Seven Brothers, has this song. I will read you the song. The song is called Sobbin' Women. I played this for Bay, and Bay was horrified. Bay was horrified, which is the correct reaction. I do not want to sway you in any way. You hear the song. Maybe you're horrified. Maybe you're not. Let's see. Sobbin' Women. Tell you about them sobbin' women who lived in the Roman days. It seems that they all went swimming while their men was off to graze. That's not what happened. Well, a Roman troop was riding by and saw them in their me-oh-mys naked. So they took them back home to dry. Least that's what Plutarch says. Oh, yes. And the women was sobbin', 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 fit to be tied. Fit to be tied is angry. I had to look that up. I mean, fit to be tied, you mean they tied them up? Like, no, fit to be tied is that they were angry. Every muscle was throbbing, throbbing from that riotous ride. Seems they all cried and kissed and cried all over that Roman countryside. So don't forget that when you're taking a bride. Sobbing, fit to be tied from that riotous ride. They never did return their plunder. The victor gets all the loot. They carried them home by thunder to rotundas, small but cute. And you've never seen, so they tell me, such downright domesticity. With a Roman baby on each knee named Claudius and Brute. Brute is right. Bunch of brutes. Now, the story of the rape of the Sabine women may not have actually happened. It was perhaps propaganda spread in the first century BCE to support the uniting of Italy, the continent, because there were domestic wars. What do they call that?
The social wars?
They weren't quite civil. Were they the civil wars?
I think you're trying to say social wars.
The Italian wars. Anyway, they were warring with the tribes around them because the Rome is a city and they had to conquer Italy and they had to do all this other stuff. So they were warring with them. So it may have been war political propaganda to spread this story of the rape of the Sabine women being like, look, we did this terrible thing. We did this terrible, terrible, terrible thing. However, look. Look how we now all get along, despite the terrible things we did in the past. Rome be doing terrible things. But then they give you civilization. So it's like, Rome. But then it's like, okay, Rome. Back to the song. This is Six Brothers Replies. Because in the movie, Seven Brides for Seven Brothers, there are seven brothers. And the oldest, Adam, big, strong. They're all red-haired. To distinguish them from the brown-haired people of the town. They're all red-haired. He goes into town. He's like, yo, I need a wife. This is frontier times in the 1850s in the United States. So this is a frontier. They weren't, I don't think it was a state yet. But the women to men ratio was way off. So every single woman there had a lot of men being like, yo, you want to get married? 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 And the people in town are like, Adam, redhead, oldest of the seven brothers, you cannot marry our women. They're spoken for. Go back to your mountain and leave us alone. And he's like, you know what? I'm marrying this woman. Finds a very pretty girl, marries her, lies, doesn't tell her he has six brothers that she's going to have to take care of. So she comes, finds that there are seven of them, and is like, yo, you needed a worker. You didn't want a wife. Our definition of wife that we have now is totally different from what a wife had to do historically. Like, now, we do have to work. I'm not saying we don't have to work. We do have to do a lot of work. But we have to do so much less work than was expected even 100 years ago, because we have appliances, because technology has advanced to the point where, you know, one or two man hours can do what it used to take 10 man hours back in the day. I remember I had a history professor who used to say that his grandmother would say, to keep a house, you need at least two Irish girls. So it is what it is. It's history. Back to the song. Six brothers. Oh, yes. And the women was sobbing, 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 passing them nights. So crying for many nights. While the Romans was going out, hobbing, nobbing, starting up fights. They kept occupied by sewing lots of little old togas for them tots and saying, someday women folk'll have rights. So they, in the song, not according to the story, I've explained the story to you. In the song, see these women bathing, these daughters, these wives, take them, impregnate them, force them to have these babies, and the women, they're crying the whole time. Sobbing women. S-O-B-B-I-N. Sobbing. Sobbing women. And they're saying they kept them occupied by sewing lots of little togas for them tots and saying, someday women folk will have rights. Gideon, passing all of them nights. Adam, just sewing. While the Romans had fights, because the Romans were warriors. They were going out, messing up the whole countryside, and what are the women supposed to do? They've already been kidnapped. Now, in the story, according to Plutarch, in the story that gets thrown around, is that the women were taken back to Rome, and that they were offered full citizenship, and that they would be taken in marriage. It wasn't just like they took them and then raped them and then forced them to have their babies. That's what the song says. But according to the story, which itself may have been propaganda, whatever, we're not going into that right now, but that they were still respected. And in the movie, when they go and take these women from town, which they do because the imbalance of the genders and the politics of the town was like, no, you're not taking our daughters for wives. When they go and they take the women from the town, they do not rape them and force them to have their children. I'm not going to spoil the movie. It's actually on HBO. Watch it yourself. Don't take it to heart. Obviously, you cannot go and kidnap a wife. You have to trick them into marrying you of their own free will. Okay, back to the song. While the Romans had fights. Caleb, hey, listen to this. Now, when their menfolk went to fetch them, them women would not be fetched. Frank, it seems them Romans catch them, that their lady friends stay catched. Adam, right. Now, let this be because it's true. A lesson to the likes of you. Rough them up like them their Romans do, or else they'll think you're touched. What is touched? Unbalanced mentally. They'll think you're deranged. They'll think you're like a little loopy. So rough them up like them Romans do, or else they'll think you're touched. Is this a commentary on Roman values? Is this a commentary on frontier values of the 1850s? Is this a commentary on 1950s values? Oh, yes. Them women was sobbing, 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 buckets of tears. My pail. Is this a call and response? On account of old Dobbin, Dobbin really rattled their ears. What is Dobbin? To inform against or report them to the police. On account of old Dobbin, Dobbin really rattled their ears. I don't know what that means. Okay. Oh, they acted angry and annoyed, but secretly was overjoyed. You must recall that when corralling your steers. Women are steers? Okay, this is super sexist. Brothers, oh, them poor little dears. Six brothers and Adam. Oh, yes. Them a women was sobbin'. Oh, yes, weepin' a ton them sobbin' women. Just remember what Robin, oh, yes, Hood would have done. Them sobbin' women. We'll be just like them, but merry men. Oh, yes, them sobbin' women. And make them all merry once again. Them gonna be sobbin' for a while. Oh, yes. We're gonna make them sobbin' women smile. So this song, this musical number, which I will link at the bottom because I have to. I can't play it because for copyright reasons, but I'm gonna link it at the bottom. So this song was them formulating the plan to go into town and catch the women. And they were like, yeah, they're going to be crying at first. They're going to be mad at first. But they want it. They want it, you know, because they're big and strong and rough and tumble. And women want big and strong and rough and tumble men. And so they'll stop crying and then they're going to like it. They're going to like it, you know. Yes, there has been a Bollywood version of this done. Yeah, they're going to like it eventually, especially once they have kids, you know. Duh. Anyway, spoiler alert now. If you are going to watch the movie, you can turn this video off right now. But I'm just going to let you know what happens in the movie Seven Brides for Seven Brothers. They go, they kidnap the women, they trap them in the mountain with an avalanche. There's an avalanche which naturally traps them over the winter. They do not rape the women. Millie, who is Adam's wife, says, you do not rape these women. Y'all go sleep in the barn. Adam is like, I'm not sleeping in the barn. I'm a man. I'm big and strong. And he's the biggest, strongest man. And Millie had already married him by this point, so it's too late for her. Anyway, he's like, I'm going to go stay in the cabin. You deal with this. Deal with the mess I have made. This is our protagonist. This is Adam. Okay. Deal with this mess I have made. I'm going to the cabin to be by myself because you yelled at me. You yelled at me for kidnapping your six friends from town. So he's mad. He goes stays in the cabin. Okay, fine. Turns out Millie is pregnant. This whole time, Adam's in the cabin, not contributing anything, not doing anything. Fine. Millie is pregnant. She's running the house. She's corralling the brothers and keeping the women apart so they don't, there's no hanky-panky. Millie has her baby. One of the brothers goes to Adam and says, your wife has had a baby girl. And he's like, a girl? And then the brother says, you're acting like a real jerk now, Adam. I know you can lick me, but I'm going to punch you in the face. And he punches him in the face. He's like, that's because you're being a jerk. And Adam doesn't lick him because it's his brother and Adam was being a jerk. So Adam eventually comes back to the house, comes back and is like, I'm really sorry I did that. I'm sorry I kidnapped these six women. I'm sorry I've been in a cabin avoiding my responsibility while you gave birth on your own. Millie is the star of the movie. Let me just say that right now. Millie is the star of the show. And then Adam says, I wouldn't want anyone to kidnap my daughter. And so we're going to bring the women back. We haven't hurt them. Anyway, so they get ready to bring the women back. The mountain pass opens up again. The fathers come through. Fathers, brothers, whatever. They decide not to fight because if the brothers had fought their fathers or the women's brothers, they could have caused a lot of heartache by hurting the women's family. So we didn't want that. They didn't want that. So they said, we're going to bring them back. Someone hears a baby cry. Whose baby is that? All the girls, because they love these brothers. They did want to get kidnapped, okay? They wanted it. Such an archaic way of thinking. The women wanted it. So they said, oh, it's my baby. So they're all forced into a shotgun marriage at the end. And the brothers are rewarded for their awful behavior with beautiful, beautiful wives. And the rest of the men folk in town, well, screw all them. If you want something, you got to take it. You know what? Fortune favors the bold. Have we learned nothing? But that's the story. And the story in real life is that which I don't know how true it is that they were married and there was actually a long drawn out war between the Romans and the Sabines. But eventually it was mended and they became one people because of the relationships through intermarriage, through blood. So they became one people, and that's super, super sweet. Was it propaganda? Who cares? Who cares at this point? I think if it's propaganda for long enough, it just becomes the truth. It becomes accepted history, so whatever. There's multiple movies made about it. There's a musical number, so we're just gonna say it's what happened. So that is the song, Sobbin' Women, from Seven Brides for Seven Brothers, 1954 Warner Brothers. Really a fantastic musical. It's got one of the best numbers when they're doing the barn raising. That number is one of the best musical numbers I have ever seen in my life. So there is that. Also, the story hinges on kidnapping these women, which is bad. You don't kidnap a wife. You woo a wife, you court a wife, you trick a wife, but you don't kidnap a wife. And Romans too. This is supposed to be a black mark on Roman history if you believe the accepted version. There's this great there's this great art piece which is carved out of marble, I believe it's carved out of marble, and it's three people. It's a woman at the top, and she's reaching, and then there's a Roman taking her, and then there's her husband holding onto her feet, her old husband. Okay, get rid of that one, right? We're going to trade up for a Roman now. So get rid of that one. And the Roman is holding her because he wants her as a wife. And her other husband is there like, but you're my wife. You're my wife. We have a life together. And the Roman's like, might make right. Mine now. And that's the history of Rome. Subscribe.